And if you are a fan, you will know that that is the opening sequence of Flashpoint. We are joined by one of the stars right now, David Paetkau. How are you?
Welcome
back to Vancouver.
Thank
what are you,
you.
Doing
Welcome
here?
Home.
Yeah. I'm here to see family, have fun. I got a little 2-week vacation and we're going to tour around BC. And
nice.
Nice.
Do you guys often, because you're shooting the current season, season 4 right now, you guys are sort of a little more than halfway through. Do you usually have a break at some point where everybody scatters?
Yeah, for, you know, so no one goes completely insane, you need to have a break. And so, yeah, the cast and crew were all scattering for 2 weeks. And
yeah.
Then we come back and we shoot 5 more episodes to finish off the season.
And you guys have already been confirmed for season 5 as well, which has got to be, I mean, not only satisfying because you don't have to think about what's coming next, but as a cast and a crew and everything else, really satisfying to know that, you know, people appreciate what you're doing this much.
Yeah, and it's a luxurious position to be in. I mean, to know you've, you know.
Yeah.
2012, I'm working.
You're all good.
Yeah, it's
now,
great.
You can tell your family it's
totally.
Okay. I got a job next year.
I can't believe it's season 4, because remember when we had you on when this first started, you were moving to Toronto. How are you liking Toronto?
I actually quite like Toronto.
You sound surprised.
No, that's all right. You feel like you have to apologize when you're on the West Coast.
Kind of. People are really nice, and the city's great. And, yeah, so we do like it out there, but coming back, I mean, this weekend in Stanley Park at the
you hit some of the live concerts.
125, whatever, but, it was great.
You know, having known you for many, many years, I know hockey has a very special place in your heart, and you were talking today. We're not going to talk about the Canucks, although you were probably the only guy in Toronto that was really like, come on, boys.
I tell you, I lit a car on fire on Queen Street. No one joined in.
Nobody helped.
I was like, come on.
Come on, guys.
But
we
you just sort of dropped this little thing when we were talking this morning. You're like, well, yeah, it's been kind of fun because I've been playing outdoor hockey throughout the...
Oh, I know. This winter, I live in this neighborhood where there's an outdoor rink with like slopes where kids can toboggan, and it's dreamy.
That's
like
so
winter
Canadian.
Wonderland. And then 5 minutes away, there's an official hockey rink, outdoor hockey
rink. For real outdoor
hockey.
Yeah,
so I was able to play every day if I want.
How crazy is that? I mean, as a West Coaster, you know, sort of born and bred, when you go somewhere where that is literally just part of the culture, it just seems like a dream to me.
Yeah, because I know growing up, we skated on a lake. We were fearful that we would fall through
at
all times.
But you did it anyway.
Well, it was once every 3 years. The lake was
if
frozen
you were lucky,
enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So it was embarrassment of riches, and that's
okay. Let's talk about Flashpoint. That was the season opener just aired. Tell us what's going on with your character Sam Braddock. Where's he at this season?
Well, he's towing the line between being a good employee and being and compromising his whole unit with his love affair.
Yes.
So he's being quite dastardly. Well, not dastardly.
It goes against the code. It might endanger the team. What are
I know,
you thinking?
What's it called? I can't remember, but there's priority of life.
There you go.
Ah.
See, if I think that if my, you know, the Sam Braddock and Jules get, their relationship gets in the way of helping somebody,
right,
it can cause
then
a lot of trouble.
Are you going to take the relationship or not? And this is kind of, I mean, this has got to be fun for your character as well, because it's a whole other aspect. And I think that's part of the attraction of the show, and it always has been, is that slowly, you know, you sort of piece together who everybody is and what their desires are and what
their
loves
are. Yeah, and you humanize them, and you create some empathy, and, you know, it helps, I think, because when, you know, these crazy hostage situations or these, you know, it's kind of nice to know what's going on in the back of these.
Do you take your shirt off more this season? Because,
are fan sites everywhere.
When you have to Google your friends, and every Google image that comes up is shirt off.
They got to warn me, because, you know, that'll take some CrossFit. And
so you got to get ready for it as you go.
Now, what are we looking at here? This is from the season opener?
Yeah, this is we get to use all these new toys, as you can see, and... we're about to attack a guy, so we use this thermal imager to figure out where he is in the room, and we go in and kick some butt.
Now, how much is real as far as getting cops on the set to advise you guys and your equipment? How much is the real stuff that cops would do?
Off the top, at the beginning of the show, it was a lot. We had a guy there all the time and showing us the ropes, and he actually got in a little bit of trouble for
showing you too much.
Showing some of these
it was too real.
Tactical things that they use. Like, oh, that's kind of, should be off the record, actually. So, you know, we're not as real as, obviously, we have to fictionalize things.
Yeah.
And we have to make it TV, you know, friendly.
Like the thermal thing. I don't know.
I mean, the thermal thing, that's a real device.
What?
But these guys can't, you know, the they can't afford it. You know, some of the toys that we use, the cops are like, man, I wish we had
I wish
that.
We had those little drones
That's
and
cool.
stuff
like yeah, that. Yeah.
How much does this make you appreciate? I mean, especially when you're going through a character arc like sort of Sam is this year and trying to balance life with job and everything. I mean, what you forget sometimes is that there are guys who do this for a living, and sometimes the prices and the sacrifice that they have to make to balance the work with their life and their kids and their love and all that stuff is crazy.
In Toronto specifically, there's been a couple cops have lost their lives in the line of duty recently, and just in the most tragic circumstances. And you know, we meet a lot of cops there, and they're fans of the show, you know, 90% of it. And so yeah, it's quite humbling to meet these guys and to.
It must make you watch the news differently when you can relate.
Certainly. Yeah. Well, I don't know if I can relate. You know.
A little bit. In
but
a
I definitely appreciate what they do, and you know. They are heroes. You know?
Yeah, for sure. So you guys finish off this season, and then what do you do? Do you get a big break after you finish off the next five? And
yeah, so I'm free to do whatever.
You're unemployed.
I'll be unemployed for 4 months.
Nice. But knowing that you're going back is the great thing for an
it's
actor.
It's the best thing ever.
Yeah. I was looking at your IMDb stuff, and you have a couple of interesting film projects that.
Yeah, I did a hockey movie called Goon. That's going to be coming out in the fall.
Jay Baruchel
wrote it and starred in it. Sean William Scott, Eugene Levy.
Oh, that'll be fantastic. Robert.
And after talking about hockey and how much you love hockey, you didn't play hockey in this.
I know. I could play hockey. And I wasn't allowed to play hockey. It was quite frustrating. But, you know, in between takes, I could go skate.
Go out and skate a little bit.
Well, Dave, thank you so much. Nice to see you. Enjoy your time off. Of course, you can watch Flashpoint. It airs Friday nights on CTV.
Just take your shirt off for a few ones.
He's out of here. He's going to do it.
He's gone. We're going to take a break and come back with more right after this. We'll do it at the same time.
No,
okay, ready?
Don't, please.
One,
awkward.
Two.